Hi, my name is Miss Gigi, and today I'll be doing a bit of a tour on Scratch. So let's get started. First, head into Scratch. You can either have the app, a link, or you can just search it up on Google. I have the link. Here are other people's projects. So what other people have shared to the community and what they have done. This is the community. There's also the Scratch team, and there's featured studios that you can add your projects to and all of that. Projects, featured studios, Scratch Design Studios, Zero Gravity, what the community is remixing, and what the community is loving. Okay, first, click on Create to create a new project. Okay, whenever you get a new project, it will always appear with Sprite 1, which I call the cat, or the Scratch cat. And this is your coding area. It's where all your code blocks go. These are your code blocks. You've got code, costumes, and sound. It will always start, when you get a new project, it will always start with either a pop or a meow. That's fun. Here are all the types of blocks. So it's easier to organize. You've got motion, looks, sound, events, control, sensing, operators, variables, my blocks. So you can also create your own blocks like this. You can create a block. So you can make a block. And you can make a block. So here you can get an extension. So there's music, pen, video sensing, talk to speech, translate, and makey makey. You've also got Microbit, Lego Mindstorms, Lego Boost, Lego Education, WeDo, Go Direct Force, and Acceleration. To change your sprite, you can click on the little cat with a plus sign near its ear. Then hover over it, and there will be choose a sprite, paint, surprise sprite, or you can even upload a sprite. To delete the sprite you have, you can click on the sprite. It will have like a little purple box around it, like that, and then click on the little dustbin. Click on it. It'll ask you again. Are you sure you want to delete this sprite? Click yes to delete it. So I deleted my sprite. To get a new sprite, you can just click on that. And you've got all these sprites you can choose from. There's bear walking, beetle, bell, everything you can imagine for. Well, there's not everything. You can search for one, so maybe I search for a banana. Banana. That's not how you spell banana. Whatever. Or I could search for maybe a princess. There, princess. Oh, it doesn't show it. Oh, there we go. Princess. Click on it. And your petition will soon arrive, but mine is somehow not arriving. You just have to wait. Okay, there. Do you have a mini princess figure over there? To know that you're making blocks for the princess, to choose a background, go to this area next to the sprite icon. It says stage. Backdrops, and there's a little icon that has a little backdrop with a plus sign. You can choose a backdrop just like you're choosing a sprite, but it's in the background. So you can choose all of these. You can also search for one. So maybe I'm going to search for garden, or maybe a castle. Okay. Castle. So we've got our castle right there. To move your sprites, click on motion. Motion is the main one. Motion is the one where you can move the sprites anywhere. Looks is where the sprite can say something, or it can look somewhere, or it can say, or it can maybe switch a backdrop or switch a costume. See, when you go costumes, you can paint your character. You can literally paint it. So you can like edit your character. If you don't like blue, you can change it and make it light. You can choose a color. So let's say maybe the easiest one is red. So let's just do red. No, it won't look good, but it's fine. Do red, and we're going to click on the little paint box right there. Going to see, hover over it, and I'll show you what it's like. Click on it to make it turn red. And we can do the same here. Red, red, red. Oopsie. Wait. And then, oh, red. And then another one. Ah, I can't do it. Let's just leave it. It's just for example. So yeah, you can do that. I want to make it red actually. And that, and last one, that, and last one. Ah, okay, let's just leave that one. So yeah, that's your princess. And you can also make it into like different shapes. So you can make a little square. Yeah, you can make the dress a bit more boxy, and you can move the square around. So you can move it right there into there. Now it's almost completely covering the princess. You can make the square big. Oops. Don't want to make it that big. And you can to undo, press this one, this little arrow, or this little arrow. So you can do the exact same for the backdrops. This is where your princess will go. So the width is 2, so we can just call it Y. So we'll make it 5. Boom, goes up that much. Okay, let's make it 100 to make it go really up. Boom, yay, that's nice. Well, it's not really nice, it's just showing you how it's done. You can also do the same of where, if it's gonna go left or right. So let's make it 200. No, 200. It won't do anything. Well, so let's make it 58. There, it'll go over there. That's cool. And you can add more sprites, as many as you like, and you can make the princess show. You can make the princess hide. Show, hide, show, hide, show, hide, show, and hide. Okay, so let's move the princess down a bit. And we can make some text, so we can also create new sprite, and we can start from scratch and make painted ourselves, so we can make maybe we can make a little. So let's get this and make this black. Okay, and we can make a little person. Whoa, my gosh, oh my gosh, I'm so bad at this. That's why I always choose a sprite or upload it. So hard. And I'm gonna make a little body. Wee! Oh no, that did not look good. And, it's kind of like a balloon. Anyway, I love to do this. So I always love to make little speech bubbles. And they're really fun because you can also put some text in the speech bubble. So, text. Hello. We can choose a different font. Maybe a marker. Hello. That's nice. You can move the sprite around. Oh no. So, let's move the sprite. What am I doing? Oh yes, you can also move different parts of the sprite. So you can hold on one of the little bubbles and make it like that. I love doing this because it makes it so easy. If it's so bad, you can just make it easier again. It kind of looks really bad. So, yeah. Yahoo! So cool. It's like it's 3D. So, yeah, let's undo this because it's a bit bad. Just delete it. And there we go. And to start your project, you click on the green flag. To stop it, you click on the red flag. And that's, oh, and also you can save the project or you can share the project. So if you want to share it, you can just click on the share. So I'm going to undo the share because I really don't want to do the share. So, and to see all of your stuff, just go to this little drafts area and you can see all your stuff that you've been doing. And to unshare something that you didn't want, you just press unshare. Okay, and we're gonna delete that. All right, thank you for watching this video. Bye.